Like, when I was applying to school, a lot of people were saying to me, like, it doesn't matter, like, if your school's all white, that shouldn't matter, it should be about the education and all that kind of stuff. Well, I can't get an effective education, you know, if I don't feel like I'm being represented in my school, or I don't feel like I'm being supported because of the color of my skin in my school. So I feel like in order to have a successful academic career, you kind of have to have a healthy learning environment, and that's a part of a healthy learning environment. And boy, you don't need no one else. In a race, baby, know when I'm riding it slow. In my waterfall, I make it overflow. Make you forget all about them hoes. Alright, what's up, y'all? It's your girl Promise, and I'm back with another video. So today, I am talking about my experience being Black at a predominantly white institution. I got a lot of questions about this, like, since I posted on my YouTube about the fact that I was going to Washington State University, and I knew when I applied to WSU, I was interested in, like, the whole experience for a Black person going to an all-white school. And I found a few videos, and I wanted to make sure I contributed to that archive, because I am a Black person that attended a PWI, and I have answered a few questions for people on my Instagram, and I actually had a few people submit questions for this video, so I will make sure I get through those for you guys today. And yeah, hopefully I can give you guys all the information to answer all the questions that you have. First off, I'm gonna read the demographics from my school. I have to go find them. I looked at the demographics for my school when I applied. If you're a person of color and you're applying to colleges, I highly recommend you look at the demographics first. I didn't look at the demographics of WSU until after I applied, but I didn't apply to that many schools, so I felt like I only had, you know, a few options. But when I got accepted to the school that I got accepted into, I compared the demographics amongst all the schools that I got accepted into to see what would best fit me. Our WSU demographics. Let's find, like, a little pie chart. This does not have a year on it, so I don't know, like, how accurate this is. So, we have, this is the undergraduate students. We have 60% white, 14% Hispanic, and then we have a very small percentage of Asian. And then the yellowish orange color is the Black and African American, or African American. So you can see how small that percentage is compared to all the rest of them. And then even the smallest section is dedicated to the other. So as you can see, there's a very small percentage of Black people. So now that you guys can see the actual statistics, I went to WSU for 2 years, so I didn't have the average college experience. Like, an average college experience would be around 4 to 5 years. So I only did 2, and I feel like I got, you know, enough information for 4 years in those 2 years that I was at WSU. Before I get into my experience at PWI, I wanted to say, to go ahead and put this out there, I'm not a Washington State University expert. Everyone has different experiences when they go to college. You can see this exact same video from a Black girl who went to WSU, and she could have a completely different perspective than I did. So I just wanna make sure you guys take that into account, because I'm not an expert. I don't know everything there is to know about being Black at a PWI. This is just solely my experience and, like, what I experienced when I went to WSU. So yeah, I want to start by answering some questions I got off Instagram. I posted on my Instagram story a few days ago and asked, like, people on my, I'm actually gonna read the post. Okay, yeah, so I posted on my Instagram and I said, okay, so I'm doing a video on my experience being Black at a predominantly white institution, and I know I have some people on here that go to one or are thinking about going to one. So what are some questions that you all had, or maybe a topic you think I should discuss or bring up in the video? So when I posted, I got a few responses, and I'm just going to start with the first one that I got. The first question I have is WSU welcoming towards people of color? And I'm going to just say yes. WSU, one thing that I think that is kind of, like, undermined in the WSU community is the fact that they have a pretty plentiful Black community. As the people of color community in general is just very vast. We have a whole department at WSU dedicated to students of color. And when you first get admitted into WSU, they actually have a mentorship program that's set up for people of color who are first generation students, or even students who aren't first generation, but just a person of color feeling a little bit uneasy about going to a predominantly white institution. They have a mentoring program set in place, and also a whole floor of the main building on our campus is dedicated to people of color. So there are a lot of resources on campus for people of color. As far as, like, the African American community, there is a laundry list of clubs to join, and activities that will help you assimilate into the culture of WSU. So for me personally, I joined Black Women's Caucus, Black Student Union. There's Crimson Couture, a hip hop major at dance team. We also have a National Society of Black Engineers. We have Black Men Making a Difference. We have QPACA, which is for our queer people of color. So we have a large amount of clubs that adhere to people of color at WSU, which I think makes the experience way better. And I don't want to shame any other schools, but I also got accepted into OSU, Oregon State University, and their demographics were like really bad in comparison to WSU. Like, I don't even think they had a color slot for black people. Like, I don't even think they had one at all. So when I looked my year, like about 2 years ago when I checked, so that was not a school I was interested in, because not only did they not have any black people there, but they also didn't have any programs like dedicated towards equality. So maybe your school that you're applying to doesn't have like a black student union or like black women's caucus or something like that, but like maybe they have like a multicultural student services or something like that. Something that you can get involved in that involves all people of color, because even if they have that, that's better than having nothing. So WSU has a very great system set up for people of color that are coming to WSU. And that's one thing that I will love about WSU forever. And that was actually a pretty common question that I got. I got that question a lot, if WSU was welcoming to people of color. And my outstanding answer is yes. Okay, so the second question I got is, what are some clubs or things that I could join to be a part of in the black community? So that kind of directly connects to what I said in the first question. I already listed a few other clubs that you can join earlier in the first question, as far as like being a person of color and wanting to get involved in the community. And it kind of all umbrella org underneath Black Student Union. So everyone that goes to those clubs, we kind of all, it's kind of just one big family. Like, we all have like collab meetings, and we'll like have Black Women's Caucus and Black Men Making a Difference. We'll do like a collab meeting and talk about issues like black love, or, you know, police brutality, or code switching. Like, we talk about issues that we face on campus. So I would highly recommend joining those clubs. And it's the best way to make friends and to build your own community in college. Because when you enter college, most people enter college with no friends. So that is like the best way to make friends. And everyone else there is probably thinking the same thing as you. Like, oh, I don't have any friends, I'm not gonna make any friends. And these spaces are set up specifically for that. Specifically for you to make friends and make a family and to learn about your community and how to survive at a predominantly white institution. Okay, so this was another big question that I got. Is WSU racist? I got so many people asking me that question, like, blatantly, just like that. Is WSU racist? And I'm just gonna say it like this. WSU, Washington State University as a brand, is not racist. I mean, I haven't experienced that. But there are racist people that go to WSU. That's just a given. If you think about Washington State as just the state alone, there are parts of Washington where there are no black people. And people come from all over Washington to WSU. So you're getting people from parts of Washington that they've never had to go to class with a person of color. They don't see people of color on a regular basis. So you get that kind of passive racism, or like the microaggression racism, more or less at WSU. At least from my personal experience, I did not experience any blatant, blunt racism, like straight to my face. That never happened to me at WSU. That was never an experience that I've had. However, I do know some people who have had very racist, have had racist encounters at WSU. That has happened before. And that is because what I mentioned earlier, that there are people there that don't necessarily know that they're being racist. Like, they'll probably ask you a question or look at you kind of funny or say something that's probably like not appropriate to say to a black person. That will probably happen at WSU. You'll have the group of people who are simply uneducated and don't necessarily know the rights and wrongs as far as like having a conversation with a person of color. But then you have those group of people that know that these are things you don't say to black people, these are things you don't do to black people, and they still do it anyways. So college comes with a large, a large variety of people. And I think that comes with any college, not just predominantly white institutions, and not even just HBCUs. Like, a lot of colleges come with a large array of people. So you have to be able to, that's just something you're gonna have to combat in college. It's 2020, so you're encountering blunt racism is slowly decreasing. But there are people out there that have racist mindsets, and there are people out there you probably are gonna have to put in check, because it's not that they are trying to be disrespectful. They might simply just be uneducated. So that is a problem that I experience a lot at WSU. But like I said before, I didn't personally experience any racism. So sorry, y'all, my camera been tweaking. I actually just answered a whole question and my camera was off the whole time. Anyways, okay, so this one says, what were my initial thoughts my first few days on campus, and did that later change, and what changed it? I think I should bring up this one scenario that happened. It was like probably my second week on campus. And they have like this thing on campus where you're supposed to go meet your college. So like everyone's, you know, kind of already have chosen their majors. So they have an event on campus where you can go meet up with the staff of your college and like ask some questions about what organizations they have, what clubs they offer, and like basically get to meet your teachers and like socialize with students who are also in your major, who will be in your classes basically, because you know, you guys are pursuing the same degree. So my major, for you guys who don't know, is communications, and I took the track of journalism and media production. So we had our little, they had our little event at our college, and I was going to the event, and when I got there, I noticed that I was the only Black person, of course. I think there was like maybe one or two other Black people there, but I think it was one other Black person there, and they were with somebody that was white, and they came together. So I was like, well, dang. So I was trying to socialize with people because there was one girl who I recognized from my live session over the summer. So I was trying to socialize with them and like make friends and stuff. And they started cutting me out of the conversation. Like at first it was all good and dandy because they were asking, oh, what's your name? Like, why'd you choose this major? Where are you from? Like stuff like that. And then the question came out, what sorority are you rushing for? And as soon as that question, if you're watching this and you have went to WSU, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You know exactly what I'm talking about. And as soon as they asked that, I was just like, dang. And they started talking about their sororities. And I know nothing about sorority lingo. I don't know what the sororities do. I don't know anything about it because I'm not rushing for the sororities. And I feel like a part of their mind knows that I'm not rushing for a sorority because look at me. You know, like, come on. So then they start talking about that and things that connect to it. So then after that, everything that's tailed off in that conversation is linked to the sorority, and I've lost at that point. And they start talking over me, and I try to add my two cents in there because I speak English, so I know what they're saying. So I try to add my little two cents in there to keep the conversation going and not be awkward. And they continued to cut me out the conversation, and like we were in a line waiting for something. So as the line moved forward, like they would keep reshaping the way we were standing to almost kind of cut me out the circle. And I was like, you know what? I shouldn't have to stand this. So I left and I went to like the tables and stuff to start talking to the staff, and I was trying to talk to people. And I remember a few things had happened that had set me off to leave. I think one of them was like, it was a table that was set up for a club, and everyone that had went up to the table to sign the little petition or like sign the list to be added to their emails or whatever, so you can get the email notifications. I noticed that every person that went up to the table to talk to this lady beforehand, she had a conversation with. Like, they had some kind of dialogue. Like, she'd be like, oh, where are you from? Like, oh, why are you interested in this club? Like, they said something to her, to the person that was signing the paper. And as you can imagine, I signed the paper and she said nothing to me. She said nothing to me. She didn't ask me a question. She didn't ask my name. Nothing. So I was like, wow. I said, okay, maybe she don't want to talk no more. Maybe she's just tired of talking. As soon as I left from signing the paper, she talked to the person directly behind me. I'm not even kidding. I can't make this up. I was so frustrated, and I was like, you know what? It's okay. She don't know me. I don't know her. It's good. You know, we're going to move on to the next. And I think the same thing had happened again with these two other girls I had met, and we were talking together, and we were waiting in line for something. And the two girls were talking to each other, not talking to me. Two white girls. They were talking to each other. They weren't talking to me. And one of the girls was like, oh, we should go to that table because I really want to, you know, do that club. Mind you, we had came to this table and waited in this line together as three. And when she said that, I'm thinking, okay, so all three of us are going to walk over there because we just walked over here together. They left. They left me. So that's three instances that happened back to back at one situation. So at that point, I'm just like, I just throw my hands up, and I was so frustrated. I remember I had left and I called my mom. I was crying. I was like, Mom, this is not for me. Like, it's hard to start any kind of conversation with these people. They don't want to hear what I have to say. And I was just getting so frustrated because this is only the second week of me being on campus, and I hadn't even started classes yet. This is before classes had even started. So I'm like, you know, feeling at a standstill almost. Things that helped me feel welcome between that point of me crying and calling my mom to me graduating at the end of the year was the community that is offered to me through WSU, through the clubs, through the organizations, through, you know, the staff, Miss Donna, you know, she is like the mom of the Black community. Like, she is the person that stands up for us and all the things that we fight for on campus and all of our clubs and organizations and all the people who attend those clubs and organizations when they go through academic and financial struggles. She was there to assist us. And, you know, sometimes we feel like we can't go to our advisors that they give us, or, you know, our professors, because they just don't understand. They don't understand where we're coming from and the struggles that we're enduring. That helped me learn to love WSU. Talking to Miss Donna and going to the clubs and, you know, stepping out of my comfort zone and talking to people and going to events that I wouldn't have normally went to. Doing stuff like that, you know, doing things that make you feel a little uncomfortable, is, you know, how you eventually grow to a better person. So I just want to say to remember the reason why you're coming to WSU. Like, you're going to WSU to get your education. You applied to WSU just like all the rest of their white applicants, and you got accepted just like the rest of all the white applicants. So with that being said, you should be able to be treated the same way as them and get your education the same way they would be getting their education. Now, we know as America, things are unjust. So you will experience, your experience at college will not be the same as theirs. That's just how it is. It's just, you won't experience college the same way a white dude would or a white girl would. It's just not going to be the same experience for you. But you should still get the most out of your experience. And WSU, along with a long list of other colleges, offer a lot of resources and offer a lot of assistance. And I would just say to take advantage of that. Like, take advantage of all things they have that they're giving to you. Because when you leave college and you're no longer a WSU student and you're no longer, you know, attending their classes, you know, those resources are no longer available to you. That's not something that you can take up hold of. So use your 4 years or 2 years or however long you're going to be in college and make the most of it. There are going to be people there that don't want you to be there, that think maybe you don't belong there, or maybe you didn't deserve to come to this school. So what? And you got in. Well, you were meant to be there. You were meant to be there for some reason. So get your education and have fun. That's like my biggest advice for people that are going to college this semester or this year, is just get your education, go to class, but then at the same time, have fun, live it up, but get your education first. But yeah, that's pretty much the end of this video. That was pretty much all I had to say. I don't think I really left anything out. Yeah, if you feel like I probably didn't touch on a topic, or there was a question that you had specifically about WSU or about going to a PWI in general, please feel free to comment those down below. I also have my social media and my email listed in the description box below. So feel free to submit any questions you may have about WSU or any other questions you have about, you know, just college in general. If maybe you're just a person that's worried about college, period. I'm your gal. Congrats to all my graduates of class of 2020, and good luck to everyone that is attending college for the first time in fall semester. I wish you guys the best of luck. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. In my waterfall, I make it overflow. Make you forget all about them hoes.